हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय टुडेज लेक्चर इज ऑन एस ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स। एस ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स, हियर आई हैव ए टेबल ऑन द बोर्ड व्हिच इज टेकन फ्रॉम एनसीईआरटी बुक व्हिच इज गिवन फॉर द एल्कली मेटल्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल स्टूडेंट्स, माय क्वेश्चन, व्हाट आर एस ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स? S block elements are those elements in which the last electron enters into S subshell. As the S subshell has only one S orbital, therefore there can be only two electrons in the S orbital. Therefore there will be only two groups. One we call as group 1, which is our alkali metals, which will have NS1 electron configuration, N is the principal quantum number, and there will be another group 2, which is called alkaline earth metals. And the general electronic configuration of this will be NS2. So there can be only two electrons in the S subshell. Therefore, as you can see, one alkali metals, they have one electrons in the outermost shell of the S subshell. And group 2 alkaline earth metals are those which have got two electrons in the outermost subshell of the S orbital. Here, the table is very important, students, because this will help us in understanding large number of the atomic and physical properties of the alkali metals. This table is very important. Whatever tables are given in the book, student, you must focus on them, you must concentrate and must try to understand them. There is a plenty of information on that. The first thing you can see is the atomic number. If I go from lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium, I have put like this. This is radioactive. Francium is radioactive. Therefore, we are not going to study this element. That's why I have not shown any data for this. This has a half-life which is 21 minutes. And this is the longest half-life for any radioactive element. So we are not going to study that, students. So what we have, if this is atomic number 3, then I add 8, 11, add 8, 19, then you add 18. So 8 plus 8, add 18. So what it will be? 37, add 18, like 55. So lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, here if you add from potassium to this, you have added 18, so it will become 37. This will become, add 18, 55, and then this is my 55, add 32, it will become 87. So the magic numbers 8, 8, 18, 18, 32. These are the magic numbers which I have added. So francium I am not discussing, is a radioactive element. The electronic configuration of these elements, what is the general electronic configuration? Important. So if I take lithium 3, 1s2, 2s1, that 1s2 is helium and 2s1. So this is second period, N is 2 second period, and this is the inert gas element. So I can say that for all other elements, you can see the electronic configuration: lithium, helium 2s1, sodium, neon 3s1, krypton, I'm saying potassium, Ar 4s1, rubidium, krypton 5s1. Like this, you can see that the general electronic configuration can be written as inert gas element and NS1. So the preceding inert gas element and NS1 is the general electronic configuration. They have only one electron in the outermost shell. Only one electron in the S subshell. In the outermost subshell. So here, interesting, what we have already seen, that we can write the general electronic configuration of all these elements. Therefore, we are very clear that after, they can easily ionization enthalpy, students. What is ionization enthalpy? The energy required to remove one electron from the neutral gaseous atom. So that means if I have this, what I am going to do? I am going to remove one electron. That is my first ionization enthalpy. First ionization enthalpy. Since their size is very large, they have largest size. They are, I think they are the largest size in a particular period. Therefore, it is very easy to remove the electron. They have low ionization enthalpy. Their ionization enthalpies are very low. They will readily form M plus ions. We are saying they are highly electropositive elements. They are highly electropositive elements. They will readily lose one electron. That is why they are highly reactive. Highly reactive. They are so reactive that in the air, in the water, they immediately react. They immediately react. That is why they are not found in the free state, because they will lose one electron very easily. Because after losing one electron, what is left is a stable inert gas configuration. So they are left with a stable inert gas configuration. When they lose one electron, you can see that these elements are highly electropositive and they will always form unipositive. They are forming unipositive ions. One oxidation state. The oxidation state is oxidation state plus one. Because after losing the first electron, it is very difficult to remove the second electron, because they have attained inert gas stable configuration and second ionization energy will be very high, students. The values are given here. As you can see, 520, 496, 403. And as you can see that as I go down the group, the ionization enthalpy is decreasing down the group. With increase in size, with increase in atomic size, the ionization energy value decreases, because with the addition of new shells, the outer electron is becoming farther away from the nucleus. So there's a regular decrease in the ionization enthalpy as you go down the group. As you go down the group from lithium to cesium, they become more electropositive. They are going to lose the electrons more readily, and as that is the reason that cesium is highly electropositive, it will easily lose electron. The ionization energy is low, therefore they are used in photo or solar cells. What we say, they are photoelectric. Photoelectric means they, with the light energy, they will release the electron. Except the lithium, because it has a small size. Therefore, it is more difficult to remove electrons from lithium. But all other elements, as you will go down the group, electropositive character will increase, metallic character will increase, because they are going to lose the electron readily. All will form plus one oxidation states, are highly reactive and will easily lose electron. That is why they do not occur in free state. They are always occurring in the form of the compounds. And you know why they are called alkali metals? They readily form oxides, hydroxides, and oxides will react with water to form hydroxides, and they will produce OH minus ions. So they are alkalis. Their solutions are alkaline, basic, therefore they are called alkali metals. So in the water, their solutions are alkaline, basic. Further, the second property you can see is the metallic radius here. See, I am talking of metallic radius. What is the metallic radius? Why metallic radius? Because they are metals. So what metals are? They are existing as M plus and E minus. So there is M plus and E minus. So between the distance between the metal ion, what I am saying is the metallic radius. Here, these are metals, they are losing one electron. Therefore, we are talking of metallic radius. As you can see, the metallic radius is increasing down the group from lithium to cesium, metallic radius increases. As expected, students, due to addition of new shells. So as the new shells are being added down the group, the electron is going far, the outer electron is going farther away from the nucleus. So you can see there is an increase in atomic metallic radius, 152, 186, 227, like this. There is a regular increase, no problem. Further ionic radii also, because they will lose one electron to form the unipositive ion. Unipositive ion, again the same trend is seen. There is an increase in metallic radius. And what is the story about the hydration enthalpy, student? Hydration enthalpy, very important. Very important, hydration enthalpy. What is a hydration enthalpy, students? These ions, when they are put in water, they get hydrated. They are surrounded by water molecules. These ions are hydrated. Hydrated means the water molecules will surround them. Water molecules will surround them. You know already that this water, oxygen negative, hydrogen positive. So there is, these are being surrounded by water molecules. Are smaller the cation, higher the charge, or I am saying the charge density. Charge density means, charge density is nothing but charge divided by the volume. The higher the charge density, the higher the charge, the smaller the cation, greater will be the hydration. So the smaller the cation, the more will be the hydration. Smaller cation, high charge, greater hydration enthalpy, greater hydration enthalpy. So as you can see here, that the smallest one which we have is the lithium. Lithium plus is the smallest cation, so it has the largest hydration enthalpy. That plays important role. Hydration enthalpy is largest for lithium plus. It is the most hydrated ion, which is lithium plus, and this hydration enthalpy is a negative because energy is released when hydration takes place. When hydration takes place, energy is released. So largest energy you can see in the case of the smallest cation, which is lithium plus. And next, let us see what are the melting and boiling points, students. Melting and boiling points are low, they are soft, they are malleable, and you know that they can be cut with a knife. Now why they have low melting and boiling points? Because the metallic bond is weak because they are forming M plus and one electron. They have only one electron in the metallic bonds. There is a electrons M plus and electron, only one electron is there which is involved in the metallic bond. Therefore the metallic bonding is weak. As you can see, they have low melting points. As you can see, they become soft. As you are going down, you can see the melting point is decreasing. Again a regular trend, because with increasing size the metallic bonding is becoming weak, because the size of the ion increases. As the smaller the ion, more tightly it is holding them together. Therefore you can see the melting point and boiling point are decreasing down the group. They are decreasing because it is related with the force. To melt the solid, there are two things, you know, the force of attraction and the packing of these, how strong or weak is a metallic bond. Once they become the liquid, then boiling, those crystal lattice points disappear, and simply you have to see how, what is the force of attraction between the particles so that they can boil. So they are weak, having low melting and boiling points. They are soft, that is why the sodium can be cut with a knife, and they are very well. Further, you see the density. Density is, student, mass per unit volume. As you are going down the group, you see their densities are low. Their densities are low because their size are largest size. They have the largest size. So volume is more, density is low. As you can see, the density of lithium is low. Very low density for lithium, for sodium even, and for potassium, you can see the density. They are low, even less than water. So what it means is that they will float on water. They will float on water. Water density is 1 gram per centimeter cube, and you can see this is less than that. Others like rubidium and cesium, with increase in size, you can see the density increases. Density is increasing with increase in size, but you see one exception in the density of sodium and potassium, that potassium has less density than sodium because the density is related with mass per unit volume. This is an exception, students, which is important. Otherwise, you see the density is increasing, except the density of potassium is less than sodium because density is a ratio of mass and volume. Because of the larger size of this, there is a more increase in size, therefore the density of potassium becomes less than sodium. Further, you can see, I am talking of the standard electrode potentials. What is it showing? What is standard electrode potential? Standard electrode potentials are negative. That we think Mn plus Ne to Me, these values are negative. What it means that negative, this is not going to happen. This is not favorable on the forward direction. They are more going to be favorable on this direction. They have a tendency to lose electron. That means they are acting as strong reducing agents. And as you can see, the strongest reducing agent will be this one, our lithium. So according to this, lithium is the strongest reducing agent, because the value of this is lithium value, you can see, is minus 3 point. The standard reduction potential is lithium plus 2 lithium. Most negative. Therefore, these are strongest reducing agent, and they all act as a reducing agent because they are highly electropositive. They will lose the electron rather than accept the electron. Therefore, these values are important because electrode potential values needs sublimation, atomization, ionization, and hydration enthalpy. All these sum we add to calculate the electrode potential values, which we will discuss in some other class. Now, further, you see that there is a very important thing about the flame colorations. When you heat in a flame, in an oxidizing flame, what happens, students, that the electrons are excited from lower to higher subshells, higher energy states. Then, and what will happen when these electrons are excited in the presence of a flame? You heat them, they are excited. When they will be excited, they will stay only for nanoseconds in the excited state. When they return back to the original state, they emit light in the visible region. So they give very characteristic colors, which are used for the identification of these elements. And you can see that crimson color is given by lithium, gives crimson color, sodium gives yellow color, potassium violet, rubidium red violet, and cesium is giving blue color. When you heat them in an oxidizing flame, the electrons are excited, and when they come to the lower energy states, they emit light in the visible region, students. And so therefore, this is the first part of this. I will discuss the next thing in my next lecture, students. And you can note down, this table is very important, very strong information is there. And we want to discuss each and every property according to the table given in the book.